Well, what's this we've got here, Jason?
Well, I'm here with Frank, and today we're looking at the Fronius Wattpilot, so the new smart EV charger from Fronius. So you're our brains trust with everything Fronius. Frank, why would someone go with a Fronius Wattpilot? What do you think?
Look, Fronius solutions are always integrated. They'd make best use of the Fronius inverter and couple it with the other devices. They do a hot water heater called an homeowner. Now they've done an EV charger called a Wattpilot. And the beauty of the Fronius solution is that it's integrating, it's looking at the at both the requirements of the charger and the house, and is accommodating both with a very smart and elegant technology.
So does this connect up directly to the inverter or to a power source, or how would you imagine it connects up?
This is a three-phase version, so that considering up here we've got an arrangement and we've got three-phase sockets. This is the three-phase inverter, and this would simply plug in with the appropriate hardware.
I know they do make a portable version that comes with the three-phase plug on the back that you can move around.
Right.
I think this is the hardwire version that we would install. So probably a circuit breaker and then into the inverter.
Exactly. Yeah. So they've covered both fields, where you need to take one in a portable situation and plug it in to the three-phase supply, and the other one, which is hardwired in a situation where you don't need to take this on the road. But they're obviously covering all markets by offering a three-phase and a single-phase device to suit those people who have three-phase at their home or those who have single-phase at their home.
And then there's an app where you get the smart meter to talk, and you can schedule when you want to charge or time of day. It's interesting, I think what we're seeing happen in the market is self-consumption is where it's at. You're trying to use your own power you're producing.
You would be able to prioritise, in exactly the same way as the hot water heating device works, you would be able to prioritise when you want various things to happen, and it would take care of that.
Yep, so either the cheapest time of day to charge your EV, or you've got excess solar in the middle of the day, your batteries are full, or you don't have a battery, and instead of exporting back to the grid, you use your EV and fill your EV
up. Or if you need to charge it right now because you have to go, you have to go out, then it will have that as well.
Just
covers all eventualities. They do a very good job, Fronius, of providing a complete solution.
We certainly like their inverters and their hot water system. And look, this is a mounting plate. Clever little way they've done that.
Look, Jason, what intrigues me about this thing, it's so small and so light,
it is.
And it's so powerful.
So there you go, that's the Fronius Wattpilot. And I'm going to pass it over now to Frank, the Brains Trust, and let him start tinkering with it and install it, and we'll get it up running. And maybe we'll shoot some more videos and plug it into the Tesla or any other vehicle. And I'm interested to see how they schedule and how you prioritise the usage of power. And I think from memory, you need to have the Fronius smart meter installed for this. I don't know. I'll have to check that. Coordinate. I think it talks to the smart meter on the. You have to have an internet connection, and it talks to the smart.
The smart meter basically looks at the energy coming into the property and the energy going out from the property, and makes decisions about energy flow, where it should go, whether it should go out, whether it should go into the EV, should go in other places.
There you go. Fronius Wattpilot. Good on you, Fronius.
Very, very well done.
We'll have a play.
Yep.
Thanks for watching.